So I had to come to Arizona, and then now we came to Arizona and everything's cool. And we're like, okay, we'll stay here till the spring. So running claims,
nice,
having fun.
I think in general, it doesn't really seem like it's been very busy, but you know, it's, if you got a reputation, right. And people, you've got relationships with firms, you can be busy even when it's
relationships. Super quiet. That's what it's about. It's all about relationships. You know, I started the year off. I was still working as a manager for a firm. That ended during NACA, which is, that story's been out there and it's kind of funny. We came home and then went to South Carolina for a firm. I was going to write there and do deployed dailies for a while. And it didn't pan out so well. It was a lot slower. Pretty much when I got to town, the claims dried up. They were dying before I got there, and I got there and it dried up. But it wasn't bad. And so then we jumped over to Kentucky, and I was in Lexington, Kentucky there for a few weeks. And as that slowed down, the firm that sent me to, well, that I went out to South Carolina for, they knew that I was about to head home. And they said, hey, we've got a few claims in Kentucky if you want to run those on your way home. And I had like a public entity claim. It was a city that had gotten, you know, wind damage and hail damage and several buildings there, which was great experience. I had never done anything like that type of claim before. Got to ride in a cherry picker. We had one big building that
nice.
That we had to inspect, and they had a bucket truck there and everything. And I just inspected it from the bucket truck. That was pretty cool. And nice. And then, but they made me put the safety harness on, which I didn't like. And then while I was there, they called me and said, hey, we have some church claims. Some churches have damage. And so these things were just on my route back to Texas. And I did four churches on the way home. One of them was in Arkansas. And so got back to Texas. I wasn't home in Texas a week. I think it was 4 days. And then turned around and went to Ohio. After Ohio, spending some time up there. And again, on my way home, another firm calls me and says, hey, we've got some claims that, you know, if you want to hit them on your way home. And there were commercial claims and church claims. And I hit those on the way home, got back home. And this is when we had decided, we were pretty much deciding that we were going to probably go full-time RV at this point. And then got back home, bought a new RV, and immediately we were literally signing the papers and got a call to go to Mississippi, and loved Mississippi other than it just being humid as could be. I was out there, there for 10 weeks running claims. And the only reason why I left Mississippi is because I'm old, fat, and lazy, and it was just hot and humid, and I was tired of being hot every day and sweating so much. So we made the
right.
Plus we had to get back home and get rid of our house. And so, but we were having problems with the RV that we had purchased, and we took that to the dealership that we bought it from, and they bought it back from us. And so we turned around and bought a fifth wheel. And as we were signing the papers on the fifth wheel, literally signing the papers, we received a phone call to go to Michigan. And we were saying, hey, look, we can go to Michigan 2 weeks only. That's all we can go is 2 weeks. And then we got to come back. We ended up being gone for 3.5 weeks and got back, ditched the house, had 3 weeks to get out of the house. Everything we owned, packed up, given away, all this stuff, went home. And that was stressful. And then we had choices and we just made a decision where we were going to go. It was either going to be South Carolina, Indiana, Florida, or Arizona. And I know for some reason I said, hey, I haven't been to Arizona yet to work. So let's go to Arizona. So we came out here and I've been busy, very busy and good. It's good work too.
I know.
Very having cool. A good time.
Cool. So
that's awesome. The catch up for the year. That's where I've been.
If you're a brand new adjuster working for a major IA firm, you will most likely already be covered under a blanket errors and omissions policy. You probably already pay something like $5 or $10 per claim for this coverage. And what is errors and omissions? Well, if you're accused of messing something up on a claim, your E&O insurance will step in and help you out. But what if you cause damage or injury on a field inspection? For example, your ladder falls down and smashes the insured's brand new Ford F-150 Lightning. then a general liability policy will cover you in that instance. Again, you likely have a little bit of protection through your IA firm as a newbie adjuster. However, if you've got a year or two under your belt and you make most or all of your annual income from claims work, then you owe it to yourself to upgrade your E&O and general liability coverages to be customized to you. And depending on how many claims you run in a year, there's a very good chance these policies will be cheaper for you with your own coverages. Better and cheaper? Sign me up. There's only one company that provides E&O and general liability solely to the insurance industry, and that is CPLIC, aka Kaplik. They even have drone and cyber coverages. Download the free guide all about the different kinds of insurance you as the adjuster should carry at cplic.net/adjustertv. And with more than 700 videos, there's plenty more to watch here on Adjuster TV. Don't know where to start? Just go to my videos page here on YouTube and type in a search term right here to find an answer to almost any question you have about property claims handling. And we'll see you in the next one.